thank God for blessing me with opportunity to stand in, talk to y'all, and talk to anyone. But I appreciate y'all having me here again. It's always a pleasure. And it's humbling because it's based around the words that I've been blessed to write down. And because of my good friend Phil, he has incorporated a lot of my music into the curriculum, I guess, and that has blessed me to be exposed to more people. And because, I mean, I never imagined myself when I was coming up speaking in settings like this and speaking in schools and things of that nature. So it just shows you that even when you start off on a path that you may not really, you don't know where it's gonna take you.
Yeah, exactly.
In the beginning, I was just doing music just because that's what I love to do. And just writing raps because I was just feeling like I wanted to be the best rapper in the game or the best in the neighborhood or wherever it was at the time, mm-hmm. having no clue that the gift that God blessed me with would take me all over the world. Mm-hmm. And just thinking about what my brother was saying, we were speaking just now, and he was like, man, why are you not up here? Or, you know, I mean, I don't think that everybody's meant to be so-called up here. See, up here is just a state of perception of how you perceive it. When people come to me on the streets, when people catch me coming out of the gas station or whatever the case is, and they give me what we call props on the things that I've done, that qualifies to me as being up here. Because in their eyes, that's how they look at it, and I'm very grateful for that because I know it didn't have to be that way. It could be the other direction because I have a lot of friends that came up doing it the same time I came up doing it that they're no longer doing it. Because not because they didn't have the talent, they had the talent just as much as I may have had the talent, but circumstances, industry-oriented circumstances can weigh on people in different ways. So you have people that start off and it's like, man, we gonna do this, we gonna make it, we gonna blow up and all of the cliche terms that we use. And then once the industry starts to start whooping on you a little bit, they can't take it, they kind of get out of it. Or they may not have gotten out of it what they thought they were getting in it for, instant gratification, and it doesn't work like that. When you get into the music business, 95% of the time, it's a process. And it's very hard to just ascend to certain levels. It's hard to get there. And when you don't get there when you think you should, it discourages people at times and it makes them want to give up and they don't want to do it anymore. But I think that you just really have to be built for it mentally and internally, because the truth of the matter is you're going to receive a lot more whips than you will medals in this game. But if you stick it out and make it through that storm, then in the end, or once you kind of level out, those medals will start to come. And for me, the medals are not monetary. It's not about how much money you make or how much money you have or you accumulated. The medals for me come when I talk to people like y'all, like I said, when I run into people in everyday life that may be familiar with my music or just something, a word that I may have said has had a positive effect on their life. Yeah. That's bigger than anything for me. And that type of mind state, it transcends music for me because I can just equate it to what y'all are doing. The lessons that y'all are learning here are not just to know it, it's to take it out here and be a reflection of it so you can help other people. So if I do it through rap, okay, that's one aspect, but if you do it through conversation, then it's the same impact. It's the same thing, because you may be speaking to a group of young children or young people or whoever, and one or two of them, you may say something that has a positive impact on their life, and just take their life in a whole nother direction that it may not have went that way had they not run into y'all. So everything happens for a reason. My journey is very unique to me because I feel like, and I got one of my best friends in here with me. I'm with a group called the South Park Coalition, and he's a member of the South Park Coalition for 30 plus years. And he's been on that journey with me, along with a lot of my other homies that's not here with me right now. And we have a unique journey and a unique story because as young teenagers, we were in the mind frame just like anybody else starting out there. We gonna blow up, we gonna be on, you know, a lot of us are old enough, we gonna be on Yo MTV Raps and Rap City and all the big shows and and as we went on, we started to realize, you know what? That's not really the path we're gonna take because our message started to change from just the commercialized, mainstream type message, which I don't knock that per se. I just knock some of the ways that it's done and some of the slick underlying motives that may be incorporated into that path. But at the end of the day, that's the same journey I was sitting out to be on. And we would have conversations on the phone and just like, hey, we gonna do this. I'm gonna buy my mama this house. And we would have these kind of conversations. But as the message starts to change, the message is changed by the conditions of the world. So as you grow older and mature, you start to say, you know what? I need to talk about what's going on. You know, when you're blessed to do that, then all of a sudden, those who sit in those so-called power seats who want you to be on this particular path, I want you to speak on these types of subjects, they hands off now. Because this message is not gonna be as financially beneficial as we would want it to be. But now you come to a crossroads where you say, you know what? I'ma either stick to my guns and do what I feel in my heart that God wants me to do, and that stand strong with that message regardless, or I'm gonna do what they say, I'm gonna sell out, get this money, and act like I don't know what I know. And meanwhile, people out here dying and struggling, and, you know, because I'm from South Park, born and raised, been there all my life, still there. Okay. And so it's a situation where these are things that we see every day, no matter what neighborhood, what side of town you're from. You see people that's on drugs. You see police brutality. You see fighting and gang violence and things of that nature. So how can you have a platform to possibly kind of curtail and shut down some of that through a word and not stand on it and not use it? I think that's the biggest disrespect to a gift and the biggest disrespect to the creator that you can display is to have that type of ability and use it for the wrong reasons. Now, is that to say that every song I ever made is just righteous and good? No. Because I came up, I got a history. I'm evolving as a person while I'm evolving as an artist. They actually go hand in hand. So I got a lot of songs that if you play them right now, I'd probably have to bury my head in my shirt because like, I can't give a man, why y'all playing? Please don't play that. But you know, it's just part of life. It's part of that growth process. And I started doing this when I was 13 years old. So of course you have to kind of reach that point. And even at 47 right now, I still feel like I haven't reached the point where I got it figured out. You never get it figured out. I don't care what field you're in, I don't care if you're a doctor, a scientist, a lawyer, a rapper, you never figure it out totally because no matter what field you're in, it's constantly changing and evolving. I came up at a time where I never imagined in my mind that I could sit down at a desk, at a computer, and click on a mouse and talk to somebody in German. You know, I never felt like I would see a time where I could type in some words, hit send, and in 2 seconds, Phil is at his house on the other side of town reading what I just sent to him. So these are things that technology dictates you have to grow and evolve with what's going on in the world. They had to fight me like crazy as late as 1999 just to get on the internet. Mm-hmm. Because in my mind, I'm like, no, we still sell CDs and do it like we've been doing. Like, you need to get your website. You know, so if I would have been foolish and stubborn enough to stay in that